Assalamu alaikum. Here my name is Asma Begum. I am the teacher of United Public School. And today we are going to start the first chapter, 10th class physics first chapter, that is called heat. In this chapter we have to know about so many things, so many topics we have to learn in this chapter. Topics are heat, temperature, thermal equilibrium, specific heat, melting point, boiling point, few, humidity. We have to learn in this chapter. Before going to the chapter, first we have to know about what is heat. Let us see the definition. Let us derive the heat. Let us see the what is heat. It is a form of energy. Heat is a form of energy. Heat is traveled from colder body to hotter body. We have to know about what is heat. Just see the one example, small example, to understand the heat better. We have to take a fire. We have to take a straw and we have to put the pan with water. Here fire is a hotter body and normal water is a cooler body. When we apply the fire, the water will get heat up. Here we are observing that the water gaining the heat energy. Here heat is transferred from hotter body to cooler body. This is our definition. Let us see the temperature here. Temperature is nothing but it is a degree of hotness and coolness. What is hotness and what is coolness? When the heat is entered into the body, we feel coolness. When heat energy is out of the body, we will feel coolness. Heat is measured the coolness and hotness of. It is measured a coolness and hotness of the body. It is measured a thermal equilibrium. In everything, we have the some units. We have to measure any liquid, any water. We have to measure in liters. When we measure the cloth and when we measure any distance, we measure in kilometers. Similarly, heat also measured. The measurement of unit, the unit of heat. Heat can be measured in two ways, SI units, CGS units. In SI units, heat can be measured as joule, and CGS system, heat can be measured in calories. Here one main relationship between the joules and calories. One calorie is equal to 4.186 joules. With the help of this relation, any value, if you want to change the value in joules and calories, some example, if you get some value in joules, you have to convert in the calories. We have to multiply that number which 4.186 joules. Similarly, as heat is measured, temperature also can be measured in two ways. In SI units, it can be measured in kelvins. And CGS units, it can be measured in Celsius. Here also one important relationship between the Kelvin and Celsius. Here that is 0 Celsius is equal to 253 kelvins. With the help of this relation, any value can be converted into Celsius to Kelvin and Kelvin to Celsius. This is an important relation that can be used to solve the numericals. In this chapter, we have the important relationship between the temperature and the kinetic energy. Before going to the relations, to understand the relationship between kinetic energy and the temperature, first we have to know about what is kinetic energy. Any body shows its motion, and the body possessing kinetic energy when they are in motion. And the body possessing kinetic energy when they are in motion. We have the relation between that the kinetic energy is directly proportional to the temperature. What is meant by directly proportional? Directly proportional means that if the kinetic energy is increasing, temperature also increasing. When kinetic energy is decreasing, temperature also decreasing. To understand this relation, we have to perform some activity to understand the better. Here Here is the small activity to understand the relationship between the kinetic energy and temperature. We have to take a let's perform the activity now. We have to take a small large beaker. In that we have to put the hot water first, then we have to put the coconut oil. We have to take it to hold lid, which is put on the up top of the beaker, and with the help of one hole we have to insert the thermometer till the coconut oil, and another thermometer through the hose we have to insert the thermometer till hot water, and we have to observe the both readings. We have to observe the reading of thermometers. When we insert, the temperature of thermometer of hot water is more as compared to the coconut oil. After some time, the hot water is losing his hotness and the coconut oil get heated, because the coconut oil gaining the heat from coconut oil, from hot water. The moment of kinetic energy of the molecules in coconut oil is increasing. The kinetic energy of hotness is decreasing because the temperature of oil is increasing and the temperature of hot water is decreasing. This is the relationship between the kinetic energy and temperature. When temperature is increasing, kinetic energy also increasing. The temperature is decreasing.